A couple of days ago, I received this email from Google Analytics. It's an intelligence alert notifying me that the page loading time for mobile visitors to my site has an unusual spike. And this is a feature of Google Analytics that I don't think many people know about. And in fact, you can use it to monitor your web performance metrics, which is really cool. So I figured I'd give you guys a quick overview. So first of all, let's start at the beginning. It's always a good place to start. We're looking at Google Analytics. So we just logged in. This is your regular report. This is specific to my site, so this is Invito.com. So let's find intelligence reports. For that, you need to click into Home, and you have this section here called Intelligence Events. So let's go into that overview. And what you'll see here is that Google Analytics creates a number of automatic alerts for things like number of page views, visits, bounce rates, and a few other things. And you can see that there are some alerts that are firing here already. But the real power of this functionality here is that you can actually customize it to any metric within Google Analytics. And as you may know, Google Analytics tracks web performance metrics through navigation timing, which means that we can also set up alerts and get notifications for things like page loading times, response times, DNS, and many other things. So, in fact, that's exactly what I did. That's why I got that alert. So I have a couple of custom alerts set up in my account. One is called one specifically tracking mobile, and the other one is just a generic page loading time difference. So these are actual alerts that have fired over the past couple of days. So let's take a look at one of them. We have this PLT stands for page load time. So I'm going to click on the details section for this guy right here. And what you can see here is the actual alert. So this graph here shows you the average page load time. So it's across all of my visitors for all of my pages. And on November 23rd, there's this little kind of bump right here. And this actually triggered an alert. And the best part about Google Analytics is not that it just detected that, you know, there's this little bump here, but it actually tries to infer as to what are the contributors to this bump right here. And what it figured out was that the major contributors are likely from India, from city of Chennai. And in fact, it's looking at the metrics for those segments, and it's saying that, look, on average, same day in the previous week, the page load time was about 10 seconds. For whatever reason, it's 30 seconds. That's not good. For this specific city, the page load time spiked from 7 to 90 seconds. I mean, that's terrible. That something's terribly wrong there. So not only that, but you can also click on these things right here, and it'll reload the graph and show you the page load time for this specific segment. So now we're looking at India. And as you can see, the page load time is, you know, semi-reasonable, 6, 7 seconds, but every once in a while we'll get these spikes, 25 seconds, 25, and in this case, 32 seconds. So there's something systematic going wrong here, and I don't know exactly what it is. I need to track it down. We can also drill into the specific cities and look at the same graph. And in fact, you can see that this is a second occurrence of kind of the same event. So this happened earlier, and I didn't catch this. So this is where having an alert is very, very useful. First, you'll know that something anomalous has happened. I wouldn't have detected this otherwise. And two, it can actually help you figure out what is the cause of the problem. So with that, let's actually take a look at how you would go about setting up one of these custom alerts. So let's close that. And we can go into Manage Custom Alerts, create new alert, and let's create an alert. I don't know. Let's track Japan. So Japan. Actually, you know what? We're gonna look at all traffic. So we're looking for country. So we're gonna look at country and territory. Matches exactly. Japan, that's what we want. And so here we're defining what segment of the traffic we want this alert to apply to. Then we need to specify the actual metric, which is going to be used to track the alert. So in this case, we actually have a number of navigation timing metrics that we're tracking Google Analytics. So we can look at things like response time. So this is your server response time. So for whatever reason, your server starts responding slowly to specific visitors, you can flag that here. I'm going to look at page load time. So this is the average page load time, and I'm going to trigger this if it increases by more than, let's say, 30% on a previous day, previous year, or previous week. So in my earlier alert, I just used the previous week, but you know, let's create this one right here. So that's it. We can save the alert, and Google Analytics will automatically monitor and notify you. And you can apply this against multiple profiles. Here I'm just specifying one site. You can specify the period as well. So this is for how far back should the alerts look at to detect these anomalies. So it should be a day, a week, or perhaps even a month. So that's a very quick introduction, but there's actually much, much more. And to understand kind of the power of what this gives you, you really have to familiarize yourself with advanced segments in Google Analytics. So let's cancel out of this and let's head back into our standard reports. And let's actually look at the site speed report, which is using navigation timing to track all the performance data. So here's our little spike that we were looking at earlier. And let's say we want to compare this against desktop or maybe mobile traffic. So we can click on advanced segments, and Google Analytics gives you by default a number of segments. So mobile is one, and I can compare this to, let's say, all visits. Let's hit apply, and it'll provide us with two segments. So now you can see that the orange line here is the all visits, and the blue line is the mobile traffic. So mobile is doing pretty well, you know, there's few spikes, but then look at this, the desktop or the averages for all of my businesses are fine, but mobile specifically is what's spiking. So this already gives me a way to figure out, you know, is it mobile visitors or somebody else that's contributing to this spike right here. But that's kind of cool, but let's head back here. The real power in this tool right here is the fact that you can define your own segments. So let's do exactly that. We'll create a new segment, and we can, once again, we have access to all of the Google Analytics variables. So we can say continent, let's look at Asia. We can add an or statement, so we can look at Asia or Europe. Let's add another one, so continent again. Let's see, or let's do North America perhaps. Not coming up right now. Well, you can define multiple continents or any multiple metrics, and you can also AND. So there's an OR statement and an AND statement. So we can filter down the specific segment that we're looking for. So let's add an AND statement. And here, so you can look at, you know, the hundreds of different variables that are in here, and you have access both to the dimensions and the individual metrics. So there's things like if you define goals or revenue conversions, you can actually track that here. So you can say, look, I'm concerned about visitors coming from Asia that are purchasing stuff on my site. But you also have all of the page loading time metrics in all the rest. So lots and lots of flexibility in here. And the cool part is, once you define this segment, right, so I'll show you a couple of segments that I've defined previously. For example, I have visitors from Japan that are coming on a desktop browser. And if I apply that, that's what we're looking at right here. Now that we've defined the segment, we can actually head back into Home, Intelligence events, and when we're defining a new custom alert, now you can use this segment. So instead of just saying all traffic, you have this tab here called custom segments. You can open this up, and you have all of the segments that you've defined previously. So for example, visitors from San Francisco coming on a mobile phone. That's something that I've defined specifically for my site, but you could have created a different segment which is related to registered users that have purchased something on your site in the last 30 days, for example. And then you want to alert if one of those users' page load time is greater than 10 seconds. And that's it. You save this alert, and you would get, if something bad happens, you would get an alert like this. You can go into Google Analytics and figure out what's going on, which is pretty awesome.